You're watching CNA Heroes. Here's Lisa Sweet.
Welcome to CNA Heroes. I'm Lisa Sweet, co-founder of the National Association of Healthcare Assistants. I want to thank you for watching this segment. Please share the CNA Heroes segment so that others may recognize and appreciate these extraordinary CNAs. Here we are, the second week in August, still battling COVID-19 in our nation, and nursing homes continue to be ravaged by this virus. Those of us who work in nursing homes have, to a great degree, felt forgotten during this pandemic. The news media praises doctors and nurses as heroes in the hospitals. Those working in nursing homes are working just as hard, if not harder, as nursing homes were not built to isolate during a pandemic. There's still a shortage of PPE, still long wait times for COVID testing and results, and CNAs and residents are sacrificing through this pandemic. Residents are being moved to different rooms with unfamiliar staff, and sometimes even to different nursing homes in order to cohort and mitigate the spread of this deadly virus. It's hard on CNAs and residents alike. Yet still, despite most CNAs not getting any wage increase or hazard pay, despite having to work while reusing single-use PPE, often for days, despite being exposed daily to the infectious virus, despite working many shifts without time off, CNAs stay committed to the residents, the elders they serve, reporting for work, doing the best they can with what they have, and giving it their all. And without the fanfare, there aren't people cheering from their apartment balconies at shift change. There aren't celebrities sending food, nor are there any public thank yous from those outside our long-term care community. Today, I would like to recognize a CNA hero who has worked at the same nursing home for 35 years, but has been a CNA even longer than that. Joann Brown was born in Oklahoma and moved to Arkansas as a child before moving to Texas, where she lived until she graduated from high school. In high school, Joann participated in many rodeos, and horses were her passion. She got married in 1960, has four children, seven grandchildren, and six great-grandchildren. Joann raised her kids in Texas, and she and her husband had their own fertilizer business and a hog farm, as well as their horses. She moved to Dimmitt, Texas in about 1975 and continued helping her husband with the hog farm. Her oldest was a senior in high school, and that's when she started as a nursing assistant, as they didn't even have CNAs yet. This was before OBRA. She worked at the local nursing home in Dimmitt while driving to Amarillo, Texas to take the medication aid course, which she successfully passed. She continued working in Dimmitt until 1985. Joann and her husband, with one child left at home, then moved to Tucson because the fertilizer business wasn't doing so well. In Arizona, Joann worked private duty caregiving until she applied at Devon Gables in Tucson, where she started in July of 1985. She was hired as a team leader, then promoted to physical therapy technician in 1986, and then she moved into the head of the therapy department in 2004 until 2006. Then she moved into a CNA manager role while assisting with the MDSs and just helping out however she could all over the nursing home. Joann goes above and beyond every day she works at Devon Gables. She helps on the floor even until today at the age of 77. Joann really pioneered the team leader program at Devon Gables. She was a mentor, has been a mentor for so many CNAs throughout the years, and she helps support them by creating Excel spreadsheets. Yes, she's 77 years old and can navigate Excel quite well, and she keeps the Cardex bedside care plans up to date. She sounds like a DON's dream come true. Joann is quiet and unassuming and does her job without skipping a beat. She's always there when you need her and is quite honestly one of the hardest working, loving individuals ever. She often does special things for so many residents to make them feel loved. Devon Gables is so grateful for Joann, and so am I. The depth of knowledge that she brings to their team is unrivaled. Joann deserves all the recognition in the world, especially during COVID-19. She works just as hard during COVID-19 and doesn't skip a beat. Joann Brown is a 45-year CNA and still working. Joann, you are an inspiration and a blessing to so many people. I hope you know how deserving you are to be this week's CNA hero. I ask everyone to please join me in recognizing and applauding 45 years of selfless service to our nation's elderly, 35 years at the same nursing home. Give it up for Joann Brown, CNA hero.